two tribes reflected one of the great ironies of the Cold War, that in the Western democracies, people often use their free speech to rail against their own side rather than the communist East. I was only 10 at the time, a schoolboy here at Birchfield near Wolverhampton. But even as children in this leafy corner of the West Midlands, we couldn't escape the shadow of the Cold War.
For children like me growing up in the 1980s, war was something that you read about in the history books. I was part of a generation who had never felt the thump of a bomb dropping, who'd never heard the wail of an air raid siren, who'd never seen a warplane streaking overhead. And yet somehow, the fear of war remained very real. It even invaded the sanctity of my childhood classroom.
Did you ever wonder why we had to run for shelter when the promise of a brave new world unfurled beneath the clear blue sky?
And nothing captured that fear better than a short children's book about a nuclear war.
East is East and West is West. And maybe it was a difference of opinion or just a computer malfunction. Either way, it set off a chain of events that nobody but a madman could have wanted, and which nobody, not even the madmen, could stop. This is Brother in the Land by Robert Swindells. It was published in 1984. It must be the bleakest children's book ever written. It's the story of a boy called Danny, a young lad from the north of England who's caught up in the aftermath of a nuclear apocalypse. Now, things don't go entirely swimmingly for poor old Danny. His mother is killed in the blast and they have to wrap her in polythene. His dad is blown up on the back of a truck. And his brother Ben, at the end of the book, Ben 7, dies of radiation sickness. All in all, it's not exactly Enid Blyton. Now, I was 10 when I read this, and I vividly remember the day that our teacher brought it into class. I remember, too, our growing sense of desolation as we worked our way towards the end. And I also remember something else, our dread that one day, fiction might become fact.
Indeed, a poll in April 1980 found that 4 out of 10 people thought nuclear war was coming in the next 10 years.
What would you do if you heard a warning?
Run for it. Honestly, I don't know. I'd be totally unprepared.
It's your time, isn't it? Going anywhere. You've had it, ain't you? Had it, ain't you?
Will you take any preparations at all?
What preparations you got? You've had it, ain't you? You've had it, ain't you? Nothing messing about, is it? You've had it, ain't you? Nothing much crying over spilt milk, is it?
Hello, Alison.
Hello. In the event of a nuclear war, where will you be?
Oh, my goodness me. I should be in London.
Oh, don't you have your own bunker or something?